Hey guys, I'm Dolly. Since I have been living in Sweden for 3 years, I found there were so many differences between China and Sweden. So today I want to share these things with you guys. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, you have 3 seconds to do it. 3, 2, 1. So first, Swedish people eat meatballs with lingonberry jam. It was because long time ago there was no fridge and meat went bad and it smells not so good. So Swedish people, they use lingonberry jam to cover the smell of the meat. And second, fika. Fika is kind of the afternoon tea time, something like that. So every morning, maybe from 9:30 or 10 o'clock, and every afternoon, maybe 2 or 3 o'clock, all the colleagues, they will gather in the kitchen and they drink coffee, eat cookies or some cake like canel bulle, and they talk about gossips, anything. So actually, for one day, the working hour, maybe it's only 7 hours. And in China, we have 996, so which means 9 o'clock in the morning and to 9 o'clock p.m. and 6 days per week, which is definitely impossible in Sweden. And in the same time, Sweden has 25 days paid holiday, while in China, for my age, I guess I only have 10 days. And another good thing in Sweden is if you get a kid, no matter you give birth to a baby or you adopt one, you can get 480 paid holidays. And third, the company structure in Sweden is really flat. If I have some ideas, I just need to talk to my supervisor or my boss, CEO. But in China, you need to talk to a supervisor and supervisor has his supervisor. So there are so many layers or levels between, which means if you have idea, maybe it will take pretty long time until the CEO, the decision maker, will hear it. So that's something I really, really like in Sweden. And four, when you climb mountains and you may see other hikers as well, even if you don't know them, they will still say hey or hi to you. And I feel it's really, really friendly. Well, in China, if we see someone climbing mountains, we won't really say hi. Maybe because there are so many people climbing mountains. If we need to say hi, then I need to say hi from the corner of the mountain to the top of the mountain. So it will be super, super tired. And five, Swedish is really, really important in Sweden. Unlike China, if you don't speak Chinese, maybe it's difficult for you to live, but you can definitely find friends in China. But in Sweden, if you don't speak Swedish, it may be difficult for you to join the society. But of course, there are so many international people living in Sweden, so you will still have your friend, but not the local ones. And six, Swedish people like to line up and queue all the time. No matter you buy ticket or you try to get on the bus, you always need to line up, which is really, really good, I think. But sometimes I also hate this kind of endless queue. And also, you need to make appointment all the time. No matter you want to talk to your colleagues, you need to send he or she, hey, I would love to have a call or talk to you about this one. What day, what time? Or if you want to see a doctor, you need to book appointment as well. You need to call the clinic and say, I would love to meet you and when you're available. Even sometimes when I want to meet my boyfriend, we also need to schedule. Okay, when do you have time this week? And he said Friday. And I said, I'm not free on Friday. How about Saturday? So appointment and queue are really important in Sweden. And seven, mixed gender toilet. Well, in China, we have girls' toilet and boys' toilet. It's completely separate. But in Sweden, especially in universities, it's always a non-gender toilet or mixed gender toilet, which means both woman and guy, we go to the same toilet, although not the same time, but we queue in the same queue. So for me, I feel it's really, really weird in the very beginning, and now I feel, oh, it's pretty convenient, because if it's separate, then for girls, we always line up way more time than guys. But now, guys, they need to line up at the same time as us. So it's pretty fair. And 8, it's independent relationship. Well, in China, when I date a guy, in general, the guy will pay 60 to 70%, or the guy will pay for the dinner and I pay for the movie ticket. While in Sweden, it's completely different. Here, they split the bill all the time. I mean, exactly split the bill. So I think it's also good. So if one day they break up, they don't really feel that they owe each other something. And 9, Swedish guys, when they pee, they sit there instead of standing there. So don't ask me how I know it, I just know it. I guess not all guys do that, but a lot of Swedes, they do that. It's really weird from what I learned before. Anyway, hope you like this video and give me some like, share it with your friend. And if you don't like it, just close it, because I hate dislikes, just like a pig didn't want to be a bacon. See you next time. Bye bye.